Blessings, dear viewer, and welcome to Bishop Mulandi today. I don't know whether you have struggled with forgiving someone who has hurt you. I don't know even when they sought for forgiveness, whether it was easy for you to forgive them. Today we look at the subject of forgiveness and what the Bible says about forgiveness. Here is Bishop Mulandi. Enjoy the telecast.
Tonight we are going to look at when our brother has sinned against me. Forgiveness. Okay? We're going to look at forgiveness tonight. Forgiving a brother, forgiving a sister. Turn with me to the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 18. Chapter 18, and let's begin from verse 21. Matthew chapter 18 and verse 21. Then Peter came to him and said, Lord, how often shall my brother sin against me and I forgive him? Till seven times? 22. Jesus said unto him, I say unto thee, until what? Let's read all of us there. I said to you, until seven times, but until seven times seven. 70 times seven. Correct? Correct? So 70 times seven is how many? 490 times forgiveness. Is that in 1 year? Is that in 1 day? I'm hearing 1 day. Where do you get the 1 day? Man, can you? I mean, is that humanly feasible to forgive somebody 490 times? Help us. Oh my, help us. Can you do that? Now, have you ever carried brother, I like the way the Kikuyu say, mimi si ya kubeba. Translated in Kikuyu. Eh? Ndi? Digo kuwete. Ni dir modo guwaga, kananguwete. Let's see two brothers here. And I'm going to take a young one like this one. Brother, come. Called Kimansi Kuja. Huyu kijana kubebe. Eh, diyara kubeba. It's good, but the other way around will be easier. Will be easier. Can we see? Kumbeba. He's very heavy. Now, can you imagine? Thank you. You may be seated. Can you imagine someone carrying someone like that one for a day? For 2 days? For 3 days? For 1 week? For 1 month. Let's face it, brothers and sisters, tonight. Let's face it. Is that not true that we carry one another? Somebody has gossiped about you and you feel bad. One, he has no reasons to gossip about you. He has no reason. Ameni katakata, ameni aribu. And then you don't want to talk to that person. You go 1 day, you go 2 days, you go 1 week, and you are carrying that brother. You break your back, or you break your neck, or you break your body, or you get sick. Let us admit, you get sick. A lot of sicknesses today people are carrying are not from microbial whatever and whatever. They are emotionally induced into us because of the weight we carry. There are people, I tell them, you don't need prayers. You go mess up yourselves there, you disagree, you say words to each other, you don't talk to each other, you build your emotions, and then you don't greet one another. A week goes by, another month goes by, you don't greet each other. You send your children to your dad, you send your children to their mother, you talk, through children, and you build up. So it begins to show up. It begins to show through your body because you've been carrying those weights. Are we together? Many of the sicknesses people are carrying they come from emotional problems of disagreements, okay, and of carrying one another. Carrying one another. 7 times 70. 7 times 7. 490. And I heard somebody say per day. Per day. Is that possible? Okay, there's another scripture that says, and I'll translate this. Na mkikosana na ndugu yako, kama ndada yako, usingoje jua litue. Do not wait for the sun to go down. Okay? Translating. Have you read something like that in scripture? Don't. So when you get angry, umekasirika, the Bible gives us room to kukasirika. Okay? It gives us room. But it warns us, it tells us, but do not do what? Let the sun go down in your anger. Why? Why? Because it begins to eat in your system, in your body. It begins to eat in your health when you go to sleep. What would happen if we tell somebody, mimi, nimekubeba miaka mingi sana. Na hii ugonjwa unaona niko naye ni kwa sababu ya kukubeba. Sababu ya kukubeba. Let's face it, Jack. Let's face it. The church of Jesus Christ today is ailing. And we are overtaxing pastors and preachers. Pray for me this, pray for me this, pray for me this. When we know the root cause is failure to forgive. Failure to settle issues one with another. When are we going to learn to be free enough to share with somebody? Brother, ulinikosea. Na ulinikosea sana. Na ninasikia vibaya. Na nimekuja to settle. Na kwanza mimi ninakusame. I forgive you, brother. Sister, I forgive you what you did to me. Because the question is here, because I know most of you would ask, how about I go and confront him and he does not accept? I go and confront him, you did me this, you say this is about me. And he says, no, I didn't. The other day I was handling a very tough one. People had accused the pastor in one of the churches out there. And I sat with them and I called the pastor and I said, okay, the pastor is here. You say, atieliwafanya nini? And the pastor said, no, I didn't. No, I didn't. And then the pastor says, okay, I leave church. I leave church. Pastor nikosea na akubali, I leave church. So I do my own background check and I realized that was a very serious issue. So I tell that Christian, this is what you're going to do. Because he has refused to admit, you will forgive him and you go back to church. Period. Period. Is your forgiveness only based on if he accepts? How about if he does not? What are you going to do? How about if he does not accept that he sinned against you? Are you going to withhold forgiveness? Are you going to withhold forgiveness? Okay, what did Jesus... Luke chapter 11 verse 1. Let's look at that. Luke chapter 11 and verse 1. It's the one that really talks about sin. Luke chapter 11 verse 1. And it came to pass that as he was praying in a certain place, when he ceased, one of his disciples said unto him, Lord, teach us to pray. As John also taught his disciples. And he said unto them, when ye pray, say, Our Father which art in heaven, and he went on, verse 4, and forgive us our sins. Matthew says, forgive us our debts. Luke is saying, forgive us our sins. Luke is a medical doctor, and he calls it the way it is. In fact, the sicknesses, the way Luke calls them in his book, they are medical terms. When you're studying, you find that. So Luke is the one writing this, and he says, he calls it sins. And forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Let's say that, all of us. And forgive us as we forgive those who sin against us. Forgive us as we do what? As we forgive. Now, if we don't forgive, what's going to happen? What's going to happen? If we don't forgive, what happens? We don't expect the Lord to forgive us, right? Exactly. So we walk around unforgiven because we have refused to forgive. We walk around unforgiven because we have refused to forgive one another. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. How do we forgive them? Grudgingly. How do we forgive them? Nimekusamehe lakini, I will not forget. Now, and I like that honest. When somebody says it's hard to forgive, to forget. I'll forgive you, but it's very hard to forget. That's the truth. Okay? There's a father who Jesus said, "Do you have faith for your son to be healed?" I said, "Lord, I believe, but help my unbelief." I'll forgive you from my heart. I know I'll struggle for a long time to forget. That's the truth. I'll struggle with it because it's been deep. I'll struggle with it. What is wrong in being honest? Huh? What is wrong in being honest? You know? So forgiveness on the same basis. On the same basis, there are things that people will do to you, say it about you, that will hurt for some time. But when you do the first confession, okay, I forgive you. I forgive you. Then you begin exercising that forgiveness slowly and slowly. You pronounce the first words. The healing may take a while, may not be overnight. You may avoid that person for some time, but later on you discover you're greeting that person before you are not greeting. Even when you said, "I forgive you," and you hugged him, it was like, unamuhagia bali sana. Later on, una shake hand, unamuangalia. You know, this person just like me. You know, Jesus forgive me also. You know, Jesus also forgives me. I also want to accord you forgiveness. Buona sve sana. So, there are a number of things to consider when we are forgiving. That we will be forgiven as we forgive the others. That one we need to consider. As you forgive others, that's the way you are going to be forgiven. Number two, Jesus died for me. Jesus died for me. While I was yet a sinner, he died for me. He did not wait for me to be righteous, a child of God, saved, for him to die for me. He died for me while I was yet a sinner. He accorded me forgiveness of sins while I was yet a sinner. That's what scriptures say, right? That's what the Bible says. Jesus died for me before I became. While I was yet a sinner, he died for me. So, is it possible to forgive 490 times? Let's be human beings. Is it possible? Is it possible? What do you think, Eva? Is it possible? 490? times in a day? Yes or no? Yeah? Only by the grace of God. Only by, I think that's honest. Only by the grace of God. And He provides that grace. Christ provides that grace for us to be able to accord somebody forgiveness. How about wishing that person, kwanza asafe kidogo, you suffer a little bit the way I've suffered. Is that good? You want that person kwanza asikie uchungu kidogo. And that's why we come to church and tell the leaders, how do you allow so and so to be coming to church? And you know he's ABCD. You want punishment for that person. How does punishment help you? And this is the problem with us, even children. When children are growing up, ameangukia nini mesa. Unaambia mtoto, hii mesa imefanya vibaya sana we. And then you hit the table. And the child feels very good. We begin teaching them revenge from little kids growing up. Eh? Amegongwa na mwenzake, unamuita hapo, nae unamgonga huyo mwenzake. Ndiye wakue nini? Wakue even. I believe that's wrong. I believe that's wrong. And we begin when our children are very, very small. We begin with them that early. That's wrong. That's wrong. Forgive her. Shake hands. Hug her. Not watching them pige. Ikwe the same. What do you do with the table? Talk to the table. Table, usimu pige tena, usimu gonge. Table, ukiona anakuja, ondoka. You know, hey. And parents, I had parents in Congo asking the Lord to forgive them for lying to their children. Eat your food. There's a lion coming. There's a lion that is going to eat you if you don't eat your food. And by the end of the meal time, the child has not seen a lion. And the children begin to learn, oh, so mother lies. But the other one that is very common is, ukifanya hii utaniona. Ukifanya hii nitakuchapa. Alafu anaenda anafanya. Aone vile utafanya. And the father sometimes will forget. Oh. Anasemanga hivyo. So you teach your children that wewe unasemanga hivyo. Akikuwa si atasema zaidi. Will inherit from you. There are things that are very possible to inherit. There are things that are very possible for you to leave them with your children. And I'll say, who lied first? Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, about something. There was lies in the house of Abraham. Is it Abraham? Who said, this is my... It's not my wife, it's my sister. He feared for his life. What happened with Isaac? Did Isaac do the same? Didn't Jacob do the same? And Jacob was even worse. Once alifunzwa na mamaye how to cheat. Mpaka anaenda kuchukua ngozi, anajivalisha ngozi na inashonwa. Mama anamuonyesha. Anajua, oh... Successive. And that's why today in churches you're hearing people all trying to break curses. Curses. Even a Sunday service, I pray for curses to be broken for 400 people. The following Sunday, I'm also breaking curses. The following Sunday, I'm breaking curses. There are preachers who are breaking curses every Sunday. I said, well, these curses in the Mingi. These curses are really very, very, very many. I believe once we face the Lord, Lord, we break these curses that we have carried from wherever, our ancestors, we carried them, Lord, we break them in the name of Jesus Christ. I believe the Lord hears and he breaks them. He breaks them. That is the walk I've had with the Lord to trust. When we ask, he will answer. So let's look at forgiveness. Forgiveness, as I've said, produces freedom. Freedom. Forgiveness removes any shame. It may be shameful at that time when you're discussing about that issue. Face it. Don't go around it. Face it. Yes, I did, and I'm very, very sorry. Christians, we are very good at saying the reasons why we have done it. I don't think we need to go into all the details. If I have done a mistake, I don't have to say, you know, you are, oh, you are lefanya, you know. Just face it, ask the Lord to forgive you. Because that's what the epistle of John says. If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive our sins. Now listen, the Lord forgives sins. He does not just forgive mistakes. Because Christians, we like to make it so light that it was a mistake. Ilikuwa makosa nilikufanyia. We, ni madhambi. I like to listen to the football when they are talking and they say, oh, vlani amemfanyia madhambi. Hata si dhambi ni madhambi. You frame it the way it is, ni dhambi na ni mbaya. When it is not cleared, you know, by asking for forgiveness or by forgiving, it's a terrible thing. Because we have seen the consequences. We have seen the results. The results. So Jesus tells them, not 7 times 70, but I'm looking at that verse again. 2 7 times, and Jesus said unto him, I said to thee, until 7 times, but until 70 times 7. So then he therefore now gives, and we'll close with this one, an unforgiving servant. 23. Therefore is the kingdom of heaven likened unto a certain king which would take account of his servants. And when he had begun to reckon, one was brought unto him which owed him 10,000 talents. But for as much as he had not to pay, his Lord commanded him to be sold, and his wife and children and all that he had, and payment to be made. The servant therefore fell down and worshipped him, saying, Lord, have patience with me, and I will pay thee all. Verse 27. Then the Lord of that servant was moved with compassion, and he loosed him, and he forgave him the debt. Okay, that's what happened. You cried to Jesus. You were a sinner. You didn't pay for your sins. Jesus paid for your sins on the cross. And even without asking, he accorded you. And you say, Lord, forgive me. And he forgave you, just like this servant. And after you were forgiven, listen to what this servant did. After he was forgiven, verse 28. But the same servant, chapter 18, verse 28. But the same servant went out and found one of his fellow servants which owed him 100 pence. And he laid hands on him and he took him by the throat, saying, pay me that what thou owest. And his fellow servant fell down at his feet and besought him, saying, have patience with me and I will pay thee all. And he would not, But he went and cast him into prison till he should pay the debt. Verse 31. So when his fellow servants saw what was done, they were very, very sorry, and came and told unto their Lord all that was done. Then his Lord, after that he had called him, and he said unto him, O thou wicked servant, O thou wicked servant, I forgave thee all thy debt, because thou desirest me. Shouldn't not thou also have had compassion on thy fellow servant, even as I had pity on thee? And his Lord was wroth, and delivered him to the tormentors, till he should pay all that was due unto him. So likewise shall my heavenly Father do unto you, if ye from your heart forgive not everyone his brother their trespasses. Look at those star servant. He went to the Lord, he cried unto him, and the Lord had mercy. The Lord had release him, because he begged him and asked for forgiveness. Release him, and he was forgiven. But immediately he left there, he went to look for the guys who had his money. Took them by the throat, lifted them. What do you think you are? Who do you think you are? Pay me or else. Now that he didn't pay, he threw him into prison. And after throwing him in prison, the word went around to the master who had forgiven this guy. Oh, I forgive you, but you cannot forgive your fellow servant. And that is the same thing we need to face here, Christians. He forgave me. He has forgiven me. And I cannot forgive somebody else. That's the point that is very, very important, my friends. Brothers and sisters, that Christ has forgiven you and you cannot forgive somebody else. What's going to happen with you? What's going to happen with you? Bible says, when the Lord heard about it, he turned things around. Alimweka ndani akamwambia, na wewe pia utalipa yote ile nilikusamehe. Everything changed. Can you imagine right now, you and I being thrown into prison and told, sila dhambi zote umefanya tangu ukue mtu mkubwa. Dhambi hizo zote ulikuwa umefanya kabla hujaokoka, na zile umefanya ukiwa umeokoka, zote wewe ndiye utalipa. You are the one who will pay for yourself. Because look at what you've done to your fellow servant. Look at what you have done to your fellow servant.
Thank you for watching Bishop Mulandi today. It's always a joy to have you join us. We'd love to hear from you. Send us a mail, give us a call, do us a text message, and we'd love to hear your feedback. But before you tune off, here's one of us speaking about our program, ISOM.
On ISOM Kenya, we are grateful for the successful January class. Currently, we have a March class. At the end of this month, they will be going for their internship. The May class is starting on 8th of May. And we are calling upon parents, bring your children through the program. Those who have cleared Form 4, bring them, let them experience God, let them enjoy the walk with God even as they go through the program. Aloys, thank you so much, and God bless you as you purpose to be part of ISOM Kenya in this year. God bless you.
That's it from us this week. Catch us next time for Bishop Mulandi Today. God bless you.